Welcome back. This is actually the final video. We're going to wrap up what we've created in the series and do a little bit of polish to our level, just to give you some ideas of jumping off points that you can keep this project and take it to totally new places. So now that we're done with the video, we have a base pickup, that gray block that doesn't have any physics on it. We have the battery pickup that the character can collect and get power from. The character has been upgraded to have a power level, to have a collection sphere, and to be able to collect activated pickups. We've got the upgraded game mode, which has the playing state, the game over, and the one state, so the spawn volumes start or stop spawning. So we've got text on our HUD. We actually have a HUD to show both our power level and also that descriptive text. And we've got spawn volumes that can create any kind of pickup in our world as long as it inherits from that base pickup class. So let's just go back to our project and do just a little bit of final polish and tweaking. Now again, we have these two spawn volumes in our level, the one which was, let me go ahead and build lighting really quick, which had our plain gray pickups that didn't have physics activated, and then our batteries that had the power, that had the lightning bolts that extended to the character. And we have two of these in our level, but we could create any number of them because our game mode collects them and registers them when we begin playing. But for now, we will remove the regular pickup spawn volume because that was just for testing to show, hey, our spawn volumes can make any kind of pickup as long as it inherits from that base class. So we can go ahead and delete that. Now we're going to align the other spawn volume with our room here, but let's do that from the top view. So here in the viewport, if you click on perspective, you can get the top view as well. Let's zoom out. And it looks like our room actually is not quite lined up with the grid. So let's select that really quick and hit E so we can rotate and just line that up with our grid lines. Now we can actually select the spawn volume and do the same thing where we sort of move it into the center and then scale it up so it extends over most of our room here. It doesn't have to be perfect, right? This is just kind of prototyping gameplay. There's a million other things you could add to the game, such as maybe another key press to have your character pull all the pickups in the world towards them and get the electricity out of all of them, maybe like a last ditch, about to lose the game power up. So we've got that there. Now let's go back to that view switching and go to a left view. And we didn't put a roof on our room, so we could actually move this spawning volume way up above our room. Let's also look at our player start and see where it is relative to the rest of our room. And we'll go back to the top view for that, actually, to make sure it's at least somewhat centered. So now we can switch back to perspective, hit play, and we've moved some things, so we'll have to rebuild lighting again, but we can see that batteries are falling all over the map, which is illustrating another bit of a problem here is that our decay rate is still very high, and it's not very possible to win the game at this point. So we'll hit escape, build lighting, because I think our room should be all in one, in the place it's going to end up, and go find our game mode blueprint so we can reset that decay rate. So here in our blueprints folder, find the game mode blueprint, open that up, and again, it's because we've exposed all these variables that it's really easy to tweak and change any of these here. And power to win, again, that's going to be set with code when we start playing. Other than that, I don't think we need to tweak anything else. Let's try that out and see if the decay rate of 0.05 is a little bit more reasonable. And we'll go ahead and save that too. So let's play, and yeah, now our power is going down at a much more reasonable rate, and we can actually go pick up some of these batteries from all the way across the map. Let's see, we could also work on changing our battery's spawn rate because it does seem like there aren't very many of them. Again, this is something you could tweak as you're playing the game and seeing, oh, it's actually not possible to get the power to win with the current spawn volume rate. But it looks like actually if I were to keep running around and collecting batteries, I'd be okay here and be able to win the game. So I think I can leave the spawn volume rate as it is. And look, there I won. So that's all fine. And the "you win" text is actually not standing out very much right now. So I could go make that a little bit bigger if I'd like. Let me go do that really quick. So escape to exit. Find our battery HUD. And again, you could do all sorts of things like change the color of the text based on whether you've won or lost. You know, green for won, red for lost, something along those lines. But for now, we'll just select the text block here in our hierarchy. And it looks like we can increase the size here under appearance. Let's just make that, it's 24 now. Let's make it twice as large. We'll make it 48 so you can really read. And because we've said that that's size to content, it shouldn't impact our actual appearance. So we'll save that and hit play to start. And we have our, again, our text for how to collect batteries and the batteries spawning in, so we can start collecting those. You can see our speed and material changing, obviously, as our power drains and we collect batteries to fill back up. And the last thing I'd like to tweak here is if you notice that lightning is really spread out, and that's because we did take it from the content examples, which is a slightly different use case than here in our level. So I will go ahead and tweak that just a little bit. So escape, and we'll go to the example content, effects folder, particle systems, and open up that electricity arc. It's just going to be a little bit on the initial size and the noise. So if you see the noise module here, select it, and you can see the range. And we'll pull that down to more like 4 by 4 rather than 40 by 40, and then negative 4 on the minimums. And let's just make sure there's not any. The speed should be fine. Noise range scale is 0.5. That looks okay. Let's see if that looks a little bit better when we go in and play again. Let's go find some batteries. And again, if you feel like you want to increase the spawn rate, that's a variable that we've exposed and it's totally, oh, I think I actually made that a little bit too small. So back to that module and the noise. So it was, let's go back to 12. It's a little bit less than half of what it was originally. So negative 12, oops. Negative 12, and save that, and see if that gives a little bit of a better feel. And again, feel free to say make your character glow as you collect batteries, or show the number of batteries you've collected on some sort of counter in the corner. There's a ton of other things you can do. This is just the jumping off point to get you started with some of the basic framework classes in Unreal, and also C++ programming. You could even make it a nighttime scene, play with the sky sphere and the directional light a little bit there. So I hope you enjoyed this series. We'd love to see what you make with it, and keep learning. Thanks.